Joe Wurzelbacher, the plumber who isn't licensed, the would-be business owner who isn't trying to buy a business, the average Joe who has an agent and a publicist and is trying to get a book deal and a country western recording contract. He will be going to Washington if John McCain is elected. Our number one story, John Cleese is here on the prospect of America's first ever Secretary of Plungers. After having some difficulty finding Joe the plumber Wurzelbacher yesterday morning, Senator McCain grabbed the opportunity to place good old Joe way up on that manufactured everyman pedestal in Mentor last night.
Let me ask to say a few words, an American hero and a great citizen of Ohio and my role model and the man I'm fighting for and small businesses all over America like him, Joe the Plumber.
And earlier yesterday, yet another rally with Joe the Plumber in Elyria, Ohio.
We're going to change Washington and I'm going to bring Joe the Plumber with me, my friend.
Something else to look forward to. One brief flashback by way of introduction to my honored guest tonight.
Election night special. There's great excitement here at the moment as we should be getting the first result through any moment now. We don't know where it'll be from. It might be from Leicester or from Luton. The polling's been quite heavy in both areas. Oh, wait a moment. I'm just getting a loud buzzing noise in my left ear. Excuse me, though.
From Monty Python's Flying Circus, a fish called Wanda, and like everybody else who's ever appeared on this program, Newsweek magazine, Mr. John Cleese. Welcome.
Hi. It's lovely to be here at last.
Belated happy birthday, by the way.
Thank you. 69. Nearly dead.
I hope not. First of all, I'll skip the idea that that tape is why my election night style is like the way it is. I don't want to blame you for it. But Joe, how did we get with Joe the Plumber? Average guy is a candidate's hero, even though he's not average. He's got an agent. He's got a book deal going. He wants to be a country western music star. How did we get here?
You couldn't write it, could you?
No.
I think the problem came when they all wanted George W. to be president because he was someone they could have a beer with. You know, he's someone you feel comfortable with.
Yeah.
I don't want a president I feel comfortable with. I want a president who's so damn smart and well-informed and sharp and a good assessor of people mm-hmm. that if I was there, I'd just keep my mouth shut so that he didn't realize what a fool I was, you know? But that seems to be the opposite of what a certain kind of, I don't know if I should say Republican, but largely it seems Republican voter wants, who's someone he's going to be comfortable with. And the Americans are terrific about not being envious about money. Compared with the Europeans, mm-hmm. they seem to be very envious about intelligence. And the idea of actually being with someone who's sort of intelligent, well-informed, and educated, you know, Ivy League college, not a proper American, you know? And so there's a sort of envy of that with the result that they want someone that they'll be comfortable with who is not going to be terribly bright or very highly intelligent or awfully sharp or very good judge of people. And considering it's for the job, it's the most powerful man in the world, that's rather alarming.
Yeah, if you want to go have a drink with somebody, go have a drink with them. Don't.
Well, I pointed out to one audience that if they wanted to have a drink with George W., they should vote for Al Gore, you know. Have more time.
And yet, Joe the Plumber has not been your personal highlight of this campaign. We've been teasing this all night. No. I'll play the tape first, and then you explain to me why this is so good.
If I can still speak.
Across this country, this is the agenda I have set before my fellow prisoners.
Something went horribly wrong there.
My fellow prisoners. Yes. Now, you see, the funny thing is, we've seen this a little bit on television, but they should be talking about this. The one is, if he addresses this large crowd as my fellow prisoners, what's actually going on in his mind? Is he just a it's insane. I've never heard, as Michael Palin would say, oh, what a giveaway.
Yes. but if not insanity, at least it may show some sort of reticence to actually want to be on the job. Because if you're viewing, never mind what you see everybody else as a prisoner, you're still a prisoner?
Exactly.
Right, let somebody else run.
I spent a week trying to think of something that was stupid and to say that my fellow prisoners, and I absolutely couldn't come up with anything.
Nothing.
No.
Even expanding the realm outside this country.
It's absolutely perfect. I think anybody who could vote for the guy after he said that.
Yeah.
doesn't know anything about psychology.
But there's nothing from Neville Chamberlain that rhymes with this.
Oh, I have this piece of paper.
But it wasn't an election campaign read.
It was just the future
of the world that he was holding up in his hands.
That's right. You know what Hitler said? He said he seemed such a nice old gentleman that he wanted my autograph. So.
Listen, I was honored about a month ago to read your great Hannity poem. Do you have a further piece of
yes,
work?
Yes, I have another one I've been working on.
Can we have the appropriate lighting for Mr. Cleese?
Oh, thank you. It's about a fellow called Bill O'Reilly.
I've heard of him.
Yes. Are we ready?
Yeah, he was a character in Fawlty Towers, as I recall. He was the construction guy. Oh, no, that Bill O'Reilly.
All right. Bill O'Reilly's no spin zone is rated highly by his own beloved mother, but no other. Except that Bill, for all his faults, still has one skill, a skill of sorts. He can amuse a true dumb ox, the dullest crayon in the box, the kind of ox that watches Fox. And Bill will pander to this group with propaganda, right-wing poop, and knee-jerk views and censored news. Thus, Bill O'Reilly earns his crust, behaving vilely as he must. He will not shirk from Rupert's work. He really is a perfect Burke.
Obviously, I love the sentiment behind it, and much of that, the Fox and Ox and Box stuff, is a wonderful, beautiful... what I'm getting at is... The Burke at the end?
Oh,
what is
well, it's, that's
what is
English. I'm sorry. I think Americans don't know it as well, but it's Cockney rhyming slang.
Cockney. Well, I've heard of that, but what... I mean, that's a substitution process, but what is Burke supposed to rhyme
well,
with?
It rhymes with the Berkeley Hunt.
Oh, okay. we had the other day Karl Rove complaining about John McCain not getting sleazy enough with this Rashid Khalidi, who's a fellow that Obama knew.
Yes.
And it turned out McCain funded to the tune of $500,000 in 1990, so maybe they should have left it alone. But Rove said, oh, you should have gone and started this in April. I mean, should they just brought him out of retirement or off Fox and had him do the commercials?
I was speculating, this guilt by association thing, I was thinking if Rove was on the Democrat side, by now he would have run something about John McCain saying, this man, the so-called hero, spent 5.5 years of the most formative years of his life in a communist country, speaking only to communists. He never had to pick up the tab. He got free accommodation. He got free food. Do we want someone as president who has been palling around with communists? In other words, you can tell the truth, but if you leave certain things out, you can really turn it on your head. Of course, what he did in Hanoi was magnificent, but I'm just showing what could be done by anybody who wants to use that guilt by association.
Is there any hope for our political system at this point, or anybody else in the free world, or should we just?
I wish you'd do just one thing, and it's about the only thing we get right in Britain. We do not have paid political commercials.
Would that? How many ills would that actually solve?
Well, it would stop that soundbite bit.
Mm.
You see what I mean? And it would stop the enormous amount of money that has to be generated.
But that pays my salary to some degree.
Well, that's true.
John Cleese, actor, comedian, Obama supporter, poet, and a veteran of Cockney rhyming slang. Pleasure having you here, sir.
Thank you for what you're doing, Keith.
My pleasure.